Further confirmation of what we knew perhaps even 3 years back, that it really has been the end of one era. Real Madrid miles ahead with their stadium rebuild, winning the title and yet again the Champions League last season. Not long ago, Barca seemed beaten both at the bank and on the field. We should have known better. A magnificent march. They bounce clear in La Liga and they have the advantage as we get going in this second leg. Confidence must be high, Glenn, but the last thing you said to me before we came on the air, it's still Real Madrid, and they win when they're not meant to.
Yeah, they love the big games, don't they? And this is a big game for them. They've got to make sure that they don't concede early. I think that would be a big shock to them. They'll be nice and tight. I think Ancelotti said they were not going to go gung-ho from the first minute, but they'll try and contain them and take the pace and take the rhythm into this game and control this game. I think that's what they'll be looking to do, take the ball away from Barca, and Barca will have to play on the counter.
Alaba leaves it to Kroos. Barca can leave well alone there. Koundé looks like he's going to play it right back. For Xavi's got so many options across this back line. And the other thing you and I discussed, how has he actually put this back line together so effectively?
Well, that's the thing. You think of Xavi, of a creator going forward, a midfield player, but they're a side that don't concede goals. I mean, they may have possession of the ball most of the game, in a lot of the La Liga games, but this will be a slightly bit different. I feel that Real Madrid are the ones that are going to have possession.
And now Araujo out on the right. Maybe we were right first time. Out on the left side and picking it out of the light so well. Gavi, what a clearance that was. Camavinga, the unaccustomed Real Madrid left back, but he was needed there. A lightning break from Barca.
Yeah, that's what they've got to look for, that little counter-attack. And Gavi showing all the skills that he's got there. Look, they get in behind there, puts another great ball in there. And Camavinga, great defending on the cover there. You don't really see him play left-back that often. He's normally in the centre of midfield, hasn't he, this season, when you've seen him for Madrid. But gets round on the cover tremendously well, keeps it away with his left foot.
Rafinha's corner. Busquets. Full of belief here, Barca, with every reason. That seemed to be on the upper body, let's put it like that. Gavi's leading the protest. The referee seemed to indicate chest or stomach.
I think it hit his arm, actually, but it's whether his arm's really sort of away from his body. It's, if he's tucked it in close to his body, the referee's saying no. And VAR looked like they've made a very quick decision there.